Very good morning, dear students. Welcome to Learning Radius. Welcome to Learning Radius Current Affairs 2021. And in this video, we'll be discussing another 10 topics of international relations. And don't miss the earlier videos. Keep an extra eye on the earlier videos and watch it carefully. And in today's video, we'll be discussing another 10 topics. And the topics are FATF, BRICS Medium Forum, India and US signed MOU on intellectual property cooperation, 7th India Suriname Joint Commission meeting, Bangladesh starts relocation of Rohingyas, PESEX, UN removes cannabis from most dangerous drug category, Bangladesh Bhutan, US designate Pakistan China as countries of particular concern for violation of religious freedom, and United Nations Investment Promotion Award 2020. So in this video, we'll be discussing 10 topics, and the 10 topics are United Nations Investment Promotion Award 2020, US designates Pakistan, China as countries of particular concern for violation of religious freedom, Bangladesh-Bhutan relationship, UN removes cannabis from the most dangerous drug category, PESEX, Bangladesh starts relocation of Rohingyas, 7th India-Suriname Joint Commission meeting, India and US sign MOU on intellectual property cooperation, BRICS Media Forum, and FATF. Let's come to the first topic, that is FATF, Financial Action Task Force. In the annual joint expert meet, the Financial Action Task Force has appraised about 400 experts from both the public and private sectors of the latest risk finding related to money laundering and terror funding. It was attended by participants from various government agencies all over the world and international bodies such as United Nations, International Monetary Fund and the World Bank and Interpol. So in the discussion in the annual joint expert meet, the Financial Action Task Force has appraised about 400 experts from both the public and private sectors of the latest risk finding related to money laundering and terror funding. So here, annual joint expert meeting as it has done. So we should have clarity what is Financial Action Task Force. And the key highlight of the meeting was FATF said it attaches great importance to effective information sharing, which is one of the cornerstones of well-functioning AML-CFT, that is anti-money laundering, combating the financing of terrorism. So that is, FATF said it attaches great importance to effective information sharing, which is one of the cornerstone of well-functioning of AML-CFT. AML-CFT is anti-money laundering, combating the financing of terrorism. At the meeting, experts exchanged ideas on issues such as financing of ethnically or radically motivated terrorism, their transnational links, environmental crime, illegal arms trafficking, and terror financing and digital transformation. And participants also focused on the linkages between illicit armed trafficking and terrorist financing and the need for national risk assessment to address the risk. So there were keen discussion into different activities, and the Financial Action Task Force fundamentals should be clear in your mind. So Financial Action Task Force is a global money laundering and terrorist financing watchdog. The intergovernmental body sets international standards that aim to prevent this illicit activities or illegal activities and that harm the society entirely. FATF worked to generate the necessary political will, bring about national legislative and regulatory reform in these areas, with more than 200 countries and jurisdictions committed to implementing them. Next topic of discussion is BRICS Media Forum. The 5th BRICS Media Forum was held virtually. It was held to coincide with the recently concluded BRICS Summit. Media organization discussed ways in which journalists from grouping could collaborate more closely to tell stories with the countries facing many similar challenges from economic issues to public health as they grapple with COVID-19. So here the discussion is about BRICS, and BRICS Media Forum was held virtually. Representatives called for the five nations, Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa, to work together to jointly combat the virus of disinformation in the pandemic era. So BRICS is in discussion, detailed clarity regarding the fundamentals and the foundations related to BRICS should be there in the mind. And a significant discussion, a common thread was growing problem of disinformation of fake news. Disinformation is being transmitted globally at warp speed on the so-called technology platform, notably Facebook, Twitter, Google, WhatsApp and Instagram. So that was a major concern and that was a major area of discussion. It's a major threat not just to the mainstream media, but more importantly to the lives and well-being of tens of millions of people and the safety and integrity of society as a whole. So that's about BRICS Media Forum. And BRICS Media Forum that launched in 2015. BRICS Media Forum mechanism was proposed by Xinhua News Agency and jointly initiated with mainstream media from Brazil, Russia, India and South Africa. So that is about BRICS Media Forum. The BRICS Media Forum mechanism was proposed by Xinhua News Agency and jointly initiated with mainstream media from Brazil, Russia, India and South Africa. The forum aims to establish an effective, efficient coordination mechanism among the BRICS media, advance innovation-driven media development and gather stronger momentum for the development of BRICS countries through exchange and pragmatic cooperation under the mechanism. So that is about BRICS Media Forum, which is formed in 2015 and I conveyed what's the aim about. So have a clarity regarding BRICS Media Forum. At the same time, BRICS as an organization should be very clear. Now the four forums were held in 2015, 2017, 2018 and 2019 respectively, which issued the Beijing Declaration of the BRICS Media Forum, the action plan of promoting BRICS Media Cooperation as well as action plan of BRICS Media Forum for 2018, 2019 and 2019-20. Several documents have been incorporated in the BRICS Summit Declaration too. So the earlier submits of BRICS Media Forum also should be clear in your mind. Next discussion is about India-US signed MOU on intellectual property cooperation. So India and US have signed MOU, Memorandum of Understanding on Intellectual Property Cooperation, Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, Ministry of Commerce and Industry signed the MOU with US Patent and Trade Office, Department of Commerce of the US. The Union Cabinet in its meeting dated 19 February 2020 gave the approval for signing the MOU with United States Patent and Trademark Office in the field of IP cooperation. So India and US have signed MOU, that is Memorandum of Understanding on Intellectual Property Cooperation. Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, Ministry of Commerce and Industry signed MOU with US Patent and Trademark Office, Department of Commerce of US. So this is the discussion related to India and US signed MOU on Intellectual Property Cooperation. And Union Cabinet in its meeting dated on 19 February 2020 gave approval for signing the MOU with United States Patent and Trade Office in the field of IP cooperation. So fundamental intellectual property, UPSC can ask. UPSC asked good number of questions before related to intellectual property right now. India and US sign MOU on intellectual property. The MOU aim at increasing IP cooperation between two countries, facilitating exchange and dissemination of best practices, experiences and knowledge of on IP among the public and between and among the industry, universities, research and development organization and small and medium-sized enterprises through participation in programs and even organized jointly or singly by the participant. Collaboration in training programs, exchange of expert, technical exchange and outreach activities, all these are coming under the IP cooperation between India and United States of America. So India and US signed MOU on intellectual property cooperation. Try to have complete data in your mind related to India's cooperation. At the same time, what is intellectual property right is about? And very basic fundamental is now India and US signed MOU, and that can be a direct question, which is a country in which India is related with, in connection with intellectual property right. In that level also, UPSC can ask an easy question. So it is India and US signed MOU on intellectual property cooperation. Next one is the 7th India-Suriname Joint Commission meeting. The 7th India-Suriname Joint Commission meeting, co-chaired by the Minister of State for External Affairs, Mr. Muralidharan, and the Minister of Foreign Affairs, International Business and International Cooperation of Republic of Suriname, Ambassador Albert R. Ramdin, was held virtually on 2nd December 2020. So that is India and Suriname Joint Commission meeting, the 7th Joint Commission meeting, and they discussed. The discussion was held in an atmosphere of warmth against the backdrop of friendly India-Suriname relations. Underscore the importance of this mechanism in deepening political dialogue, reviewing bilateral ties and exchanging views on regional and multilateral cooperation. agreed to add new momentum to the bilateral relations in the field of business and investment with the aim to enhance, among others, the cooperation towards the establishment of creative industries, health, traditional system of medicine, agriculture, mining, energy, defense, culture and education, consular cooperation and development partnership, and strengthen people-to-people ties. So that is India and Suriname discussion and India and Suriname relationship has to be clear in your mind. Next is Bangladesh starts relocation of Rohingyas. So Rohingyas is again into discussion. So the geography behind, at the same time, the fundamental GK behind Rohingyas should be clear. So Bangladesh starts relocation of Rohingyas to the newly developed facility at Bashanchar Island. So there is another geographic location came into discussion, that is Bashanchar Island. Hundreds of Rohingyas were transported on buses from Ukhiya Degree College campus in Cox's Bazar to Chattogram Port for being taken, or Chattogram Port for being taken to the Bashanchar Island. The UN offered to engage in constructive consultation aimed at better understanding the relocation plan process and operational issues. So Bashanchar is in discussion, so you should have a clarity regarding Rohingyas, at the same time the new island, that is Bashanchar, and the geography behind where it is located. International human rights groups are opposing the relocation of Rohingyas to the Bashanchar. They demand independent assessment of the liability on the Bashanchar by the UN and humanitarian agencies before the process is started. Now, what is Bashanchar? Is an uninhabited island where the government of Bangladesh has made shelter houses for 1 lakh Rohingya refugees at an estimated cost of 2,300 crore. So that is what is about Bashanchar, is an uninhabited island where the government of Bangladesh has made shelters or shelter houses for 1 lakh Rohingya refugees. The environmentalists say that the Bashanchar falls in an ecologically fragile area prone to floods, erosion and cyclones. In April 2020, 306 Rohingyas rescued off a boat in the Bay of Bengal were taken to the Bashanchar and settled there. Now that is about the Bashanchar, and there is a relationship between Rohingyas and discussion between Rohingyas and Bangladesh, and a new location, Bashanchar Island, and the discussion related to Bashanchar and its ecological issues and all into discussion. So have a clarity on that particular location. Next is about PASSEX, P-A-S-S-E-X. That is, Indian Navy is undertaking a passage exercise with Russian Federation Navy in the Eastern Indian Ocean region from 4th to 5th December 2020. That was the discussion. So what is PASSEX? So it is passage exercise. So Indian Navy is undertaking a passage exercise, that is what called PASSEX, with Russian Federation Navy in the Eastern Indian Ocean region from 4th to 5th December 2020. The exercise involves participation of Russian Federation Navy guided missile cruiser Vyak, large anti-submarine ship Admiral Tanlev, and medium ocean tanker Kachinga. Then Indian Navy is being represented indigenously constructed guided missile Fragile Shivalik and anti-submarine Kavit Kadmat along with integral helicopters. So in connection with PASSEX, the fundamentals are conveyed. What is PASSEX should be clear in your mind. At the same time, the frigate Shivalik, the fundamentals of Shivalik should be there in your mind. At the same time, the Kavit Kadmat, what is the base behind Kadmat, and fundamental clarity regarding or fundamental GK related Kadmat also should be there. Now, what is PASSEX? It aimed at enhancing interoperability, improving understanding and imbibing best practice between both the friendly navies, and would involve advanced surface and anti-submarine warfare exercises, weapon firing, seamanship exercises and helicopter operations. So it is aimed at enhancing interoperability, improving understanding and imbibing best practices between both the friendly navies, and would involve advanced surface and anti-submarine warfare exercises, weapon firing, seamanship exercise and helicopter operations. Now, what is PASSEX? PASSEX are conducted regularly by Indian Navy with units of friendly foreign navies, well as visiting each other's port or doing a rendezvous at sea or rendezvous at sea. That is meeting with a clarity in the time and date. That is what called rendezvous. So PASSEX are conducted regularly by Indian Navy with units of friendly foreign navies, well as visiting each other's ports or doing a rendezvous at sea. This exercise being conducted in the Eastern Indian Ocean region reflect the strong long-term strategic relation between the two countries, and particularly defense cooperation in the maritime domain. It is being conducted on the occasion of Navy Day of the India on 4th December, which emphasizes the strong bond of friendship shared between the two friendly militaries. So PESEX is in discussion. What is PESEX and why PESEX on 4th December and where it is located and how? I explain all the details of PESEX conducted by Indian Navy with units of friendly foreign navies. Exercise being conducted in the Eastern Indian Ocean on 4th December. That's the discussion. Now, next is UN removes cannabis from most dangerous drug category. In reviewing a series of World Health Organization recommendations on marijuana and its derivatives, the CND zeroed in on the decision to remove cannabis from Schedule 4 of the 1961 Single Convention on Narcotic Drugs, where it was listed alongside deadly addictive opioids, including heroin. CND's 53 member states voted to remove cannabis, where it had been placed for 59 years from the strictest controlled schedules, then even discouraged its use for medical purpose. Now, the one line as it is, UN removes cannabis from most dangerous drug category. India was part of the voting majority along with US and most European nation. China, Pakistan, and Russia were among those who voted against, and Ukraine abstained. Among WHO's many points clarified, cannabidiol, that is CBD, a non-intoxicating compound, is not subject to international control. Now, related to this cannabis discussion, another organization is into limelight, that is United Nations Commission on Narcotic Drugs. So, UNCND, as like UNTRC and all, UPSC can ask about UNCND. So, what is UNCND? UNCND is United Nations Commission on Narcotic Drug. The Commission on Narcotic Drug is the principal policy-making body of the United Nations in drug-related matters. Furthermore, it is mandated to decide about the scope of control of substance under the International Drug Control Convention. So, once again, UNCND, United Nations Commission on Narcotic Drugs, is the principal policy-making body of the United Nations in drug-related matters. Furthermore, it is mandated to decide about the scope of control of substance under the International Drug Control Convention. So, once again, in reviewing a series of World Health Organization's recommendations on marijuana and its derivatives, the CND zeroed in on the decision to remove cannabis from Schedule 4 of the 1961 Single Convention on Narcotic Drugs. So, what is Schedule 4? UPSC asked about Schedule 1, Schedule 2 and Schedule 6 and all in the earlier exams and all. Now, here also again, Schedule 4 is into discussion. So, what is Schedule 4 and what is the basic objectives of Schedule 4? Has to be there in your mind. At the same time, UN removes cannabis from most dangerous drug category. So, what is UN Commission on Narcotic Drugs? At the same time, the pharmaceutical aid of cannabis should be there in your mind. Next is Bangladesh-Bhutan relationship. Bangladesh signed in its first preferential trade agreement with Bhutan along duty-free access to a range of goods between the two countries. This is the first PTA Bangladesh has signed with any country in the world. So, first preferential trade agreement Bangladesh has signed with any country in the world. The agreement was signed on the occasion marking the 50th years of diplomatic ties between two countries. So, Bangladesh signed its first preferential trade agreement with Bhutan, allowing duty-free access to a range of goods between the two countries. And as like I mentioned, this is the first preferential trade agreement Bangladesh has signed with any country in the world. The agreement was signed on the occasion marking the 50th years of diplomatic ties between the two countries. So, the history behind the Bhutan-Bangladesh relationship and the details of preferential trade agreement should be there in your mind. And the students who are listening to me, you will be getting the material related to the India discussion. So, read and understand the clarity. Now, United States designates Pakistan, China's countries, Pakistan, China's countries of particular concern for violation of religious freedom. The United States has designated Pakistan and China among eight other countries that are of particular concerns for violation of religious freedom. Key highlights: State Department placed Pakistan and China along with Myanmar, Eritrea, Iran, Nigeria, North Korea, Saudi Arabia, Tajikistan and Turkmenistan in the list of engaging in or tolerating systematic, ongoing, egregious violation of religious freedom. So, United States has designated Pakistan and China among eight other countries that are of particular concern for violation of religious freedom. The State Department placed Pakistan and China along with Myanmar, Eritrea, Iran, Nigeria, North Korea, Saudi Arabia, Tajikistan and Turkmenistan in a list of engaging in or tolerating systematic ongoing egregious violation of religious freedom. That is the discussion is about. Comoros, Cuba, Nicaragua and Russia on special watch list for government that have engaged in or tolerated severe violation of religious freedom. So this is the discussion. The United States has designated Pakistan and China among 8 other countries that are of particular concern for violation of religious freedom. So that is an international discussion right from the side of United States of America. Next is United Nations Investment Promotion Award 2020. So United Nations Conference on Trade and Development, UNCTAD, has declared Invest India as winner of the 2020 United Nations Investment Promotion Award. So United Nations Conference on Trade and Development, UNCTAD, has declared Invest India as winner of the 2020 United Nations Investment Promotion Award. The award ceremony took place on December 7, 2020 at UNCTAD headquarters in Geneva. The award recognizes outstanding achievements and best practices of investment promotion agencies across the globe. The evaluation was based on UNCTAD assessment of work undertaken by 180 IPAs. United Nations Investment Promotion Award. This United Nations Investment Promotion Award is the most coveted award for investment promotion agencies, that is what called IPA. UNCTAD is a central agency that monitors performance of IPAs and identify global best practices. Germany, South Korea and Singapore have been some of the past winners of the world. Or Germany, South Korea and Singapore have been some of the past winners of the award. So that's all about the discussion. So it's about United Nations Investment Promotion Award. So in the next video, we'll be discussing another 10 topics of international relations. Keep an eye over all these topics. Try to have a clarity regarding the current affairs and the GK related to the current affair and the basic fundamentals related to the current affairs topics too. So we'll meet in the next video and we'll be going with another 10 topics of international relations. Calm version is the most productive version. Relaxfully listen to the topics of discussion. Try to internalize the topic. At the same time, have a cross-reference too. And in the website also, you'll be getting the related materials of this YouTube discussion. So have a great time and meet you in the next video. Thank you. Thank you all.